Now, Deputy Michael Lowry, please.
Sorry to trouble you with some more mundane and practical matters, but some of you city representatives and urban centres wouldn't recognise or realise the huge problem, the massive problem we have in relation to rural and county roads. And if you live in rural Ireland and if you're an elected representative, you're met with people every other day describing the shocking, the appalling and the atrocious conditions of these roads. People living on these roads at the present time are frustrated, they're angry and they're resentful because their local road network is in tatters. This Taoiseach is a massive political issue. The government doesn't need research. We don't need surveys. We don't need focus groups to establish the extent of the problem. If you just ask your county councillors in Tipperary and around the county, there are in fact all county councillors at the present time are embarrassed and ashamed to meet people living on these roads. People using these roads right across the county in North Tipperary, Mid Tipperary, South Tipperary and West Tipperary are incensed and furious at the sheer neglect and abandonment of some of these rural roads. Due to the lack of adequate funding, council engineers and elected representatives feel helpless and hopeless. Now, Taoiseach, we've had a number of weather events. We had Storm Ophelia, Storm Eleanor, Storm Brian. And we had unprecedented levels of rainfall, snow and frost. The government did an excellent job in briefing and preparing the public for such events. And I think the message was competent, it was capable in getting precautionary measures across to the public. But the follow-up has been less than impressive. You know, after these weather events, it's inevitable that you have impact, you have consequences, such as the alarming deterioration in the roads. And the more you ignore it, the worse it gets. For example, the CEO and the executive of Tipperary County Council met last week with your Finance Minister, Pascal Donoghue, and they informed them that after they conducting an evaluation and assessment, that they require an additional 197 million to resolve the problems of 3,000 kilometres of rural roads. And if you look at the allocations, in national allocation in 2008, that's 10 years ago, was 608 million. This current year, in 2018, is 417 million, which is a drop of 200 million. Take Tipperary alone. 7 years ago in Tipperary, we got 45 million for roads. This year, we're getting less than half, 23.3 million. So, Taoiseach, this needs an urgent response from the government. It needs a coherent and orchestrated approach. And it's not sufficient to say that we have had an increase in allocation. It's abundantly clear that the Department of Transport is not going to be able to provide the roads, the funds that are necessary. We need an extraordinary response and it needs funding.
Thank you, Deputy. Taoiseach.
I had the opportunity over the Easter recess to get around the country a little bit. Was in Limerick, Galway, your own county, Tipperary, Leash, Meath, Kildare, and indeed North County Dublin. And you're absolutely right. The issue and the condition of local regional roads has very much been raised in me by citizens everywhere I go. And a lot of our local regional roads are in very bad condition. There are a lot of potholes, a lot of ruts. A lot of vehicles are being damaged too. And that's a combination of two things, a combination of underinvestment in our roads during the dark years, during the last decade, the recession, during which we just didn't have the money to invest in our public infrastructure, and also, of course, the very bad weather that we've experienced in recent times. The total regional and local road budget for this year is €417 million, and that's a €90 million increase on last year. So it's €417 million, €90 million more than last year, and that's a very considerable increase. I did some digging in the last, or metaphorical digging in the last day or two, and discovered that actually only a small fraction of that €417 million has actually been spent by the local authorities. And the answer I've been given is that money hasn't been spent by the local authorities because of the bad weather. They haven't been able to get out there on the roads to repair them. So now that the weather is getting warmer, now that the sun is starting to come out, I absolutely expect local authorities to immediately begin works on repairing our roads, to spend the €417 million that has been allocated to them for this year to repair the local and regional roads. And yes, we are giving consideration to an additional allocation on foot of the storm events. We've asked each local authority to come forward with a costing in that regard. Some have, some haven't. But before we make that additional allocation, I really would like to see local authorities spend the money that they've already been allocated. €417 million, €90 million more than last year. I understand the weather's been bad and they haven't been able to get crews out there, but the weather is now improving. The long evenings are coming and I expect local authorities to get out there, do that work, spend that money.
Deputy Lowry.
The problem is they don't have the resources to do the work. Our roads have become virtually undriveable. They're not fit for purpose. They're hazardous. They're dangerous. In fact, they're obstacle courses. It's impacting on school buses, on dairy collection services, on post deliveries, on bin collection, on ambulance services. I had a case last week where an elderly sick patient had to be brought out by tractor through the lane to meet the ambulance at the top of the road. That's how bad our roads are. And I'm saying to you, Taoiseach, today that all of us as elected representatives are getting savaged at meetings in rural Ireland across the board. We have to turn up and explain the unexplainable. It's just impossible. And I would say, Taoiseach, we have a general election on the horizon. This issue has to be dealt with. And if Fine Gael and the government are serious about re-election, they must address the issue of lack of funding for rural roads, because after the first week of the campaign, half of your canvassers will be in bed because they won't face the hostility of the people living down those rural roads and lanes.
Conclude on this matter.
Thanks. The figures supplied to me for local fund roading are funding for roads in Tipperary. So for regional and local roads, there's an increase this year to €21 million, up from €18.4 million last year. For national roads, it's an increase to €13 million from €2 million last year. And as you'll know, the local improvement scheme for laneways was reintroduced last year, and the allocation for Tipperary is €625,000, and that's up from €237,000 last year. So increases under all of those headings for Tipperary. And it's also important to bear in mind that central government grants aren't supposed to cover the full cost of roads. Local authorities are supposed to supplement that with their own resources from commercial rates and from the local property tax, as well. But what I'd ask the Deputy to do in his interactions with council officials, and I'd ask everyone to do that, to actually ask them how much of the resources that they have been deployed so far this year. As I said, €417 million is available for local and regional roads this year. I understand only a fraction of that has been spent. I understand why that is, because of the bad weather, but we want local authorities out there now, in the good weather, in the longer evenings, spending that €417 million, improving and restoring our regional and local roads. And in the meantime, the government will work on additional funding on foot of the storms.
Now, Deputy Eamon.